Welcome again, and with this some updates in my existing slide, I'm here again in continuation with the last two lecture series which I released on diameter based protocols. Okay, so nothing much updated, but just to show you, like, just to give you a recap, that we discussed, like, what is diameter based protocol, what is this the current RFC, what is the meaning of RFC, okay, which is the current RFC 6733, as you can see in the slide. And what is the governing body which is responsible for creating rules for this diameter based protocols, the messages and everything. Okay, so let's move towards the next slide. Okay, so we already discussed that it how this diameter stack is designed, and if we compare it with the diameter with the application, sorry, the OSI reference model, how it looks like. Okay, and it's a AAA based protocols, means authentication, authorizing and accounting. Okay, so it's secure, it's fast, it's reliable because it is using TCP and SCTP as a transport layer protocols. Okay, how the message look like, this is a comparison slide which I explained you, and I have just modified it a little bit better to make you understand, like, if you compare all these layers, you can I'll also share this slide with you in my channel, so you can download it and see. But this is nothing much different. You can easily get these things from the internet, Google. So basically, which of the layers are doing which work and where the diameter sits, so you can easily compare with this slide. Okay, now again, this example I show you how basically its diameter is a text message based protocols, means basically one client, one is server, and clients want to share some information with the server, and in return clients want the response from the server. Okay, so I explained you how a letter which is addressed to someone, but actual information is inside the letter, but on the envelope itself we can know that who it is addressing, from which country is the origin, okay, who is the sender, okay, and then we come up to the message whether it is related to us or not. Okay, so similarly, diameter structure is also like that, as I explained in the last lecture. Like, we have a client, we have a server, we have an envelope, like which we say as a header. So header will contain everything, like diameter protocol version, the AVP, diameter protocol version, and other things like application ID, okay, the flags, all those things, and the actual message is inside the AVP. Okay, so let's move on quickly, and these are the packet structure of the diameter. Like, we have version, command flag, message length, command code, application ID, hop by hop identifier, end to end identifier, and AVP. No need to worry, friends, as I have kept separate slides to explain you each and every part of this, but even then I'll prefer not to go much deeper, because our main motive behind this series is to give you a brief knowledge about the diameter, okay, up to the point which is actually required in a telecom domain. And then we will quickly move over to the applications which are actually using the diameter, and then we will see, like, how the messages flows in that particular applications. So if I read out, like, each type of diameter messages is uniquely identified by a command code. So yes, as I explained, like, we have different commands, like CER, CEA, CCR, CCA, RAR, RA. Okay, and these are having a separate command code, means all those commands are unique. Okay, then we have application ID. So application ID is basically the application on which that command is going on. So it's not like CCR is only made for one application. There might be multiple applications which are using CCR. The only difference is that the message inside the CCR, CCA will be different in the different applications. Okay, I will give the more brief about this in the later slides, but as of now, it's a very high level. Okay, so let's move forward. I showed you, like, how TCP dump looks like. So in the last lecture, if you see, I have showed you the TCP dump of one of my diameter node, and I have shown you, like, how physical layer, link, IP layer, then transport layer, and then at last the application layer, which is our diameter protocol layer, and how it looks like. Like, we have version, you can see the yellow highlighted part, I have compared it with the diameter protocol structure, diameter packet structure basically, and this is the version, how, what is the value inside the version. Then what is the length of this diameter message? Okay, then the flags which we are using. Okay, then the command code, application ID, hop by hop identifier, and end to end identifier. And below is the AVPs, which we will discuss later on. So let's now actually we have started with our session. So this is the new slides wherein I have explained you like what is version. So this version field must be set to 1 to indicate diameter version 1. Okay, so it is, if it is 1 means the diameter version we are using is 1. So currently the diameter version is 1 only. Okay, and then the length. Okay, so message field indicates the length of the diameter message. Okay, so this is nothing much because there is nothing much deeper to explain about the length. So you know means the message which I'm sending, I should at least know the length of the message. Okay, so you can compare it like I'm sending a letter. So generally when I go to the courier agency, they check what is the size of the letter, what is the weight of the letter, and accordingly it makes the proper arrangement like the logistics which is required to send this letter to the user. But suppose I'm sending a laptop, I'm sending a heavier thing in that, so accordingly he has to do his logistics. Moreover, the security protocols which he needs to follow for that particular packet to be delivered, that's all depend upon the length and the specifications of that particular product which I am sending in a letter or through the courier. So length is just like that. So now comes to the flag. So flag is a very important thing, and I have shown you like this. Let me highlight this part. Okay, so this is the flag. So we have this number of flags, 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 7. So first flag is R. R means request. Then P means proxyable, E means error, and T means potentially retransmitted message. So basically, this is a binary kind of field in diameter protocol header. And if any of this flag is true, that means, sorry, that has a particular relevance. Means suppose example, in this particular example, the request flag here, the request flag is set to 1. 1 means this message of diameter which is flowing from client to the server is actually a request message. So I actually don't remember whether I told you or not, but diameter protocol is just like a person who is asking something, and in return he wants some reply, and the other person has to reply to his question. Okay, so here we have request message and the answer message. So this particular message is a request message, and this flag is indicating it clearly that yes, this is a request message. And then we have a proxyable message. So proxyable message is nothing like I am person A, I have to send some message to B, but I'm not sending it directly, I'm proxying it. Okay, so there is a middleman between us which is called as proxy, and I am sending this message to him, and then he knows where the C is standing, and he will deliver this message as it is to the C. So that's why I am calling it as a proxyable. And but as it is, I am saying as it is doesn't mean that it cannot change the message. I will later explain in the next slides that what is the meaning of proxy, what is the proxyable messages, what are the agents which are responsible to deliver the proxyable messages, and what else they can do with that particular message. They can change something. Okay, so don't make a particular picture with this statement, but yes, proxyable is something different to the request and request, because request is something which in combination with the proxyable and without proxyable, it is going towards the receiver. Okay, and in our network, as you know, we have thousands of boxes, means thousands of servers. So it's not always like the sender and receiver are directly connected. And actually 99% they are not directly connected, they are always connected towards different hops. Okay, so every hop you can say might be the proxy. Okay, so let's move to the TT. If T is set to 1 means this message has to be retransmitted. Okay, and the other flags are written as RRR, means they are reserved for the future use. So means in future, if IETF is going to give some more features in the diameter protocol stack and the messages and the flags, they can use these reserved flags. So as of now, we will not discuss much about reserve because there is nothing to be discussed. Okay, so let's move to the next slide, which is okay, now these has been okay, this is the headers of diameter message. So again, we'll explain you like command code. So as I told in the previous slides, like command code, there are so many command codes, and each application has its own set of command codes. Okay, so this field shows that what exactly command code it is. So 272 is the command code, which is in digits. okay, in a normal number system, and the description of it is credit control. So it's a credit control request whose command code is 272. Friends, why command codes are used? Because these are unique IDs for each commands. Okay, and it's easy to filter out request if from the Wireshark tool, as I showed you in the previous slides, and I will show you again. Like I can even show you right now. Let's take this one. Okay, so 272. So if I write here diameter dots 272, let's say, so you can see if I write like this, I can filter out all the credit control request. Okay, and same you can see in this slide also. So this ID is helpful in that. If I write credit control, it's a text based, and you know guys, text based searching is something very difficult, so better to put better to remember the command code, or you can search it on Google what is the command code which for the command which you are searching, and you can put the filter like this, diameter.cmd.code. So diameter is the protocol, .cmd means extension we are giving command, .code means we are giving code, not text, code. So double equals to means we are comparing all the requests which are there in this packet dump, and we are putting 272 as a filter. So it's like an Excel sheet. I'm putting 272 command code filter, and it will show me all the requests which are having 272 command codes. Okay. So all these requests, if you scroll down here, all are command code, credit control. So credit control request and answer both will share the same ID. It's not like request is different and answer is different. So it's same. Okay. So let's move in.